bans the use of chemical weapons. In his first interview since winning the prize for peace, Ahmet Zumchu told the BBC that President Assad's regime has been actively facilitating the weapons experts, taking them, he said, wherever they want to go. It is remarkable progress for an organisation that has never before operated inside a war zone. The Director General revealed that one of the abandoned sites listed in Syria's declaration lies within opposition territory.
We change hands from one day to another. That's why we continue to appeal, in fact, to all sides in Syria to support this mission, to be cooperative and not refrain from, in fact, rendering this mission more difficult.
Mr. Azumchu believes the agreement on chemical weapons broke a deadlock and that it could act as a precursor or catalyst for a broader peace. The irony is that the OPCW might not have won the Nobel Peace Prize if it weren't for the devastating deployment of chemical weapons. Ahmet Azumchu told the BBC his teams in Syria have been encouraged by the recognition.
This came as a very high boost of morale to them. As you know, they are working in a very challenging circumstances. In the field. They said that it was in a recognition of its achievements over the past 16 years, but also about the challenging tasks which await this organization ahead, in particular in Syria.
Until a few months ago, it was a low-profile organization, but this UN-backed mission has catapulted it into the headlines. Mr. Azumchu is now encouraging the international community to be inspired by the OPCW's comparative success. He believes the agreement on chemical weapons broke a deadlock and that it could act